This is a full game asset workflow with all of the fundamentals covered and a complete step-by-step ancient wall project in Blender, presented by me, Aidy Burrows, and Gleb Alexandrov of Creative Shrimp.
This has to be one of the most commonly requested topics we've been asked for over the years, and we are happy to announce it's finally available.
Spread out over 10 hours of video, we'll learn how to create the asset. This is a really fun stage, learning how to bring the ideas to life using modeling, sculpting, and texturing. Then we'll learn to optimize. This, for many, can be the scary part. This is where we're here to help demystify many of the misconceptions of the more technical side of modeling, unwrapping, and baking. Finally, we export out to a game engine. You can choose any engine, though we've chosen to demonstrate the process in Godot, which is faster download, faster load, and has everything we need.
In this course, everything you need to know is in one place, from start to finish, from blockout to export, with fundamentals and step-by-step processes from those folks at Creative Shrimp. What will you learn?
We'll start off with the fundamentals of simple modeling and add more best practices and more essential tools and techniques as we progress. Ultimately, at this stage, we'll be creating a watertight mesh to make it easy to remesh later and begin the sculpting fun.
When we reach the sculpting phase, this is where we can really let loose. After preparing the blockout mesh for sculpting, we'll be using the standard sculpt brushes to handcraft the appealing scars of time, weathering and erosion and so on, marking our asset with a rich past of our choosing. It's a pretty fun and fluent process. We'll be creating custom vector displacement brushes to add an extra dimension to our sculpting, as well as how to bake out your own more traditional displacement brushes for that extra fine surface variation.
We do recommend using a pen tablet for this section. It's not essential, but it will make sculpting highly detailed models like this one much easier, and fun for that matter.
In this section, we'll explore a way of creating intricate 3D designs in Blender that isn't sculpting. Instead, it's a technique centered around extracting depth maps from any image and applying them as displacements. In other words, if you've ever thought that creating detailed ancient bas-reliefs was beyond your abilities, this image-based technique is something anyone can give a go.
We'll also briefly touch on some potentially controversial AI-driven methods, such as using stable diffusion for tasks like depth detection and, as a bonus, for generating images. This can be safely skipped if desired, though we do understand that it's also useful to stay aware of these new options cascading from Pandora's box.
An ancient wall needs an ancient material, so then it's time to set up some physically based materials. That is to say, materials that should work in any lighting setup, as they are designed to react to light in a physically realistic way. We'll be using multiple albedo, roughness and normal maps and blending them together in multiple ways using occlusion, edge highlighting, procedural noise and so on. Again, similar to as we did with the sculpting, but this time using textures, we can take advantage of aspects of our model to help enhance and tell the age and history of our ancient wall asset.
So, we've finished sculpting and finished designing our asset. At this point, we're using millions of polygons, but that high resolution isn't going to cut it in most games. That's a lot of data to have to store on disk, even for something like Unreal Engine's Nanite tech. So that's where the optimizing for game engines process will help us, a major part of which is retopology. Not only to reduce the poly count, but to make it more practical to work with by creating UVs that we'll need for our textures in game. So that's where the retopology process comes in. We cover a few different ways to achieve the low polygonal version of the mesh in the course, but we'll start off with one of the most convenient decimating methods. Whatever method we choose, we'll want to hunt for any mesh errors, how to detect them, and how to fix them, using a range of tools within Blender. We'll also consider how low is low enough when reducing our mesh, and explore many modeling tips throughout. Should we want to send it into an external engine, such as a game environment, we're going to need to start with some UVs. We'll go through the two main ways to work with UVs in Blender, using seams to mark our UV island borders, or using more automatic unwrapping methods of UVs that don't strictly need seams. Plus, we can combine these methods together. UVs can sometimes get a bit messy and accidentally overlap. So we'll go through again hunting for errors, how to find them and how to fix them, and some principles to consider in how to lay them out in the first place. Then we're on to the final piece of the puzzle, texture baking. Transferring details of the high polygonal mesh into textures that trick the eye into thinking there's much more geometry going on than there really is. There can be a lot of common baking problems that come up time and time again during a typical baking process, and we'll lay out what these all are, why they happen, and how to fix them. At that point, we've finished our optimizations and it's time to check out our work in a game engine. We'll do any last minute preparations needed before exporting, and then we'll demonstrate the process for exporting to Godot. Don't worry if you've not used Godot before, we'll walk through all the steps needed.
The whole process of creating the asset is shown step by step. In addition to creating the main game assets, woven into the project are videos on the fundamentals of each topic, giving a solid foundation and understanding on many of the choices as we go through modeling, normals, constructing our UVs and so on.
We've also included over 2 hours of extra bonus content, which shows alternative approaches to constructing the low polygonal asset, another take on the whole optimizing process from modeling to baking, with a greater emphasis on quad-based topology this time around. It gives us more control over the mesh, but it means we dive deeper down the modeling rabbit hole, so to speak.
After you've watched the course, we believe you have all you need to know to model, sculpt and texture your own designs with confidence and be equipped to find and deal with all the common errors in the game asset pipeline.
It's a complete Blender guide for game asset creation available now on Blender Market, aka Superhive, and Gumroad.